Recently, I've been getting to grips with async Rust programming using tokio, the great, and I decided I should make a short video or two about it. It's probably a terrible idea, but we're here now. So in this one, I want to introduce Tokio as simply as possible by showing the difference between writing a program that uses a lot of threads to manage a lot of simultaneous tasks and one that uses a Tokio runtime. So first I'll do it the simple threaded way, where I create a thread for each simultaneous task. 100 tasks equals 100 threads. This isn't necessarily a bad thing to do. It's a popular way to write network servers, but you know, creating and destroying a lot of threads does carry some overhead, so it would be kind of a shame if you created a thread, did not very much work at all, and then immediately destroyed it. That's where it becomes a bit of a problem. So here I am looping over a range of 100. I'm creating 100 tasks, and each one is going to finish at a different random time, between 1 and 2 seconds after it started. Since my test program doesn't have any real work to do, I'm using the sleep function to simulate a random delay. Each thread will block on the sleep until the required amount of time passes, then it will print a message saying how long it waited and what the name of the current thread is. So let's run it to see what happens. Okay, all these tasks finish at different times, between 1 and 2 seconds, and we can see that each one was running on its own thread, which was named after the number of the loop that it was in. To be crystal clear, let's run it again, but this time in the debugger. So I'm going to set a breakpoint here, right after all of the threads have been created, but none of them have actually finished yet. So I'll run it again, and let's see what the state of the program is at this point. Okay, I've hit the breakpoint. Down here in the call stack, I can see that there are a lot of threads. There's the one which is the main program, and 100 other custom threads, each of which has been created to handle one task. And every one of these is in a sleep function. Nano sleep, sleep. These threads are not doing any work. They're not using the CPU. They're just sitting there occupying memory, ready to start work again when the delay corresponding to that particular thread ends. So we can see this is kind of a waste, right? We've gone to the trouble of setting up 100 threads, but they're spending most of their time just waiting for something to happen. And, you know, this might seem like a slightly contrived example, but quite a lot of programs are actually like this. But instead of waiting for a timer, they're waiting for network traffic or a database query result or something like that. So we can improve on the situation by using Tokio. Here is the same program using a Tokio runtime. When we create one of these, it allocates a thread pool, which can expand up to a maximum number of threads. By default, it limits the number of threads to the number of CPU cores on your computer, times 2 if you have hyperthreading. But to make the example more obvious, I've set it to exactly 4 here. So I still loop 100 times to set up 100 tasks, 100 random delays, between 1 and 2 seconds, but this time I'm not creating threads. This time I'm creating Tokio tasks. To create a task, first I create a Tokio delay object, which is a future, it is a future, and I can chain onto that future with then, and specify the code that will run when the future completes. In other words, when the delay expires. I'm not going to go into how futures work just here, but the most important thing to realize is that running this code doesn't do anything here and now. It just creates a recipe, a list of steps. Step 1, wait for the delay. Step 2, execute this closure, which prints something to the console, including the name of the thread. The task does not actually begin until I spawn it onto the runtime, which I do down here. At this point, it disappears into the background. From now on, Tokio is responsible for seeing that all of the steps will be completed in order. Once they are, the task will finish, and Tokio forgets about it. So in total, I do this 100 times, spawning 100 different tasks on the runtime. Finally, I use this special method, shutDownOnIdle, to block the program's main thread until all tasks have ended. So let's run this in the console to prove that this one works. As we can see, it functions essentially the same as the previous version. We get those 100 printouts between 1 and 2 seconds. This time though, we can see that each printout is running on one of the four different threads, which have all been started by Tokio. That's 0, 1, 3, 2 gets to go sometimes. So we're actually recycling the same threads over and over to run these print closures. So let's put this one in the debugger too. I'll create a breakpoint here, start debugging, and we'll prove that this is the case. Alright, so we've got the main program thread, we've got the four Tokio runtime threads that were created for the thread pool, two others that I won't worry about right now. point is, we never really needed 100 threads. They were just spending all their time sleeping anyway. And using Tokio has enabled us to run this very small, these very small jobs by sharing, reusing the same threads over and over. This reduction in threads is not the only reason to use Tokio, but this idea of creating lots of non-blocking simultaneous tasks that can share a much smaller thread pool is a major conceptual difference. Hopefully this video explains something. Maybe I'll make some more. If I got anything wrong, please start an argument in the comments. It'll be great. Cheerio.